Welcome to Kerosi TV. Today, as usual, we are going to look at current affairs to make sure that you are updated on what is happening around the world, especially in the world of policy, politics, entertainment, business, and public policy. So today we are going to look at Ethiopia, and Ethiopia, as you might be aware, is made up of 10 regions. The way we are made up of 47 counties here in Kenya, we have 10 regions in Ethiopia. And we will focus our attention to Tigray. Tigray region is one of the 10 regions of Ethiopia, because Ethiopia is also a federal government, or they practice federalization, whereby they have a national level, and then there is regions instead of counties. So Tigray region is our focus today. Ethiopia was supposed to hold their elections on August 2020, that is last month, but it never happened because the Prime Minister, Happy Ahmed, or Dr. Happy Ahmed, PhD, had postponed the elections due to COVID-19. Everyone resigned, but the one region of Tigray did not resign. Tigray is here, this way, I don't know. This is Tigray. The map shows Tigray. This is near Eritrea, up there. So this is a region of Ethiopia, which is to the northern part of Ethiopia. And the regional government decided to go on with elections. They never listened to the Prosperity Party, which is headed by the president, Dr. Happy Ahmed. So they formed, at the Tigray region, they formed what we call Tigray Regional Election Board. So they did not even wait for the National Election Board to give them directions. They decided to form their own board, like the IBC we have here in Kenya. And they decided to go ahead with their elections, despite the National Assembly stating that the elections which was planned by Tigray was unconstitutional. It was non-binding and non-applicable, which means it has no consequences at all. But they went on. The elections were undertaken yesterday by 6 p.m. yesterday on 9th of September. By 6 p.m. they had voted in 2,600 polling stations, and they had elected their leaders. So we are expecting that by 13th of September, we will know who won the elections in the, because they were electing members of assembly, because they have a regional assembly with 190 members. So that continued. The upper house called the formation of the electoral board in the region illegal, because it is like in Kenya we have the IEBC, or Independent Electoral and Boundaries Commission, which we have here in Kenya. This role is to conduct elections in Kenya, to conduct by-elections when a member of parliament has died or is incapacitated or has been removed from his seat using various techniques which are provided by in the constitution. Tigray national government called any attempts to stop the election a declaration of war, which means that they were ready to use violence or to use force if the federal government tried to stop them. Because if, for example, the federal government of Ethiopia used the force to stop them from holding the elections, then they could have responded with force, which means that they believed in what they could do in terms of responding with violence. Ethiopian lawmakers voted to extend their terms, which were supposed to end in October 2020. So basically now, the Prime Minister and members of Parliament are going to stay in power beyond October, because elections have been postponed indefinitely. So the Tigray People's Liberation Front, which is TPLF, is the regional one of the, it is actually the ruling party in the Tigray region, was sidelined when the president, or the prime minister, sorry, when the prime minister was forming a coalition which brought him to power, and when they formed the Prosperity Party in 2018. 3 million people, actually 2.7 million people, were expected to participate in the elections on September 9th, which was yesterday, and the results, as we said, are expected by 13th September. Tigray Independence Party advocates for secession of the region from Ethiopia. So the key word here is secession. Secession is when a section of a country wants to be independent, to have their own president, to have their own sovereign region. That means they have a president, they have a deputy president, or a prime minister, whichever system they may want to operate under. They have parliament, they have their own passports. That is the objective of secession. When people feel like they are not getting what they expected from a certain country, they decided to secede. For example, Eritrea seceded from Ethiopia, which means Eritrea was at one time part of Ethiopia, but now it becomes independent, actually seeking for independence. According to the East African, which is a newspaper, reporters who went to cover the elections in Tigray region were, I quote, forcibly removed from a plane heading to Mekele in northern Tigray. Mekele is the capital city of Tigray. So some reporters heading there to cover the elections were forcibly removed from the plane, and I'm told that their gadgets or equipment such as phones, laptops, ID cards were taken away from all passengers, and there was no indication when or where they could collect them from. So one of the persons who was in the plane heading to Tigray region was Simon Marx, a correspondent for New York Times, and Politico. Politico is a popular blog on politics. He had arrived at Addis Ababa airport for the flight before officials stopped him and took away his gadgets, just like the others. So what could have the federal government done? One, according to the crisis group says, and I quote them, to diffuse the situation, Tigray should pause its election plans, and Addis Ababa should embrace talks over potential compromises. So what is required is dialogue between Tigray region or Tigray regional government and the federal government and the people, that is the general public, so that there is talks, people agree on what they should do going forward. Those are the news from Ethiopia, from Tigray region, on elections which are very unique, which were unlikely, and we will see what will happen in that region, because on 13th we will be checking out to see what took place, because I'm told apart from we were told that most of the journalists never covered the elections as usual, and I don't know if there were observers, but we will find out on 13th the outcomes of those elections. That is the end of this story. Thank you for tuning in to Kerosi TV. See you around.